guys, it's summer. Well, I just got off the bus, and after yelling freedom for a couple of minutes, I went inside and I decided to make my big end of the year video. So I'm not the type of person that's gonna, you know, be all like, it's just so sad. I really don't want it to end. I'm the type of person that's happy it's over, but happy that it happened. See, I'm in eighth grade and my school makes a big deal about graduating because, you know, it doesn't go on to high school. See, I'm still in my uniform. So, yeah. Okay, so my mom told me that I was gonna be home alone for a while. That means I can say dirty words. Wiener! That felt good. Before I talk to you about anything, I want to tell you something that has gone on in my life. I have what you may know as Tourette's syndrome. Tourette's syndrome is a neurological disorder characterized by tics, and tics are uncontrollable muscle movements or vocalizations. I have both muscle movements and vocalization. When I see my tics, I have to do them. So, some of my tics include rolling my eyes, blinking a lot, and blinking hard. Moving my eyebrows really weird, jerking my head and shaking my head, and, opening my mouth like that. I'll chirp, and then I will bark. Never said a cuss word because of my Tourette's. Some other things that I'll do is I'll flap my arms, and then I'll jerk my arms forward. There goes my chirping. But I can edit out all of those. The things I can't edit out is my eye rolls and my blinking. And I really don't want to take it over and over again just because I blink and eye roll. So that's why I'm telling you. And you probably would already find out. Just saying. Back to the video. I think it would be awkward if the guy who discovered milk from a cow had to tell the people what he was doing to the cow. I think it's funny how in scary movies, people are just like, is anyone in there? As if, you know, the bad guy's just gonna be like, yum, in the kitchen, you want a sandwich? Whoever broke Adele's heart really made her rich. Asking to be friends after a relationship is having your dog dying and your mom saying that you can still keep the body, or you even being kidnapped. And the kidnapper says, you know, can we still keep in touch? I'm not very good at, you know, social things. My favorite pickup line is, you know, if you were a booger, I'd pick you first. See, I'm the kind of person that would text a girl and say, well, I heard you like Bad Boys. Well, I don't mean to impress you, but I didn't wash my hands when it said to in the restaurant. Or I press the handicap sign when I'm not handicapped. Or, you know, I sometimes enter through the exit door. Or when Disney told me to go on their website, I didn't. Now, since all of those things annoy me, I think I would just put a list together for people to, you know, annoy other people. Lay on the floor and pretend you're a carrot. Talk to your blender and say it truly listens to you. Tell your parents that wearing clothes is against your religion. Decline to be seated at a restaurant and simply eat their complimentary mints at the cashier. With a serious face, order diet water. Buy a lot of orange traffic cones and reroute your whole house. Tie bells to all of your clothes. Light rods on your birthday cake. Leave tips in restaurants in Bolivian currency. Don't respond to people unless they call you conquistador. As much as possible, skip rather than walk. Stand over someone's shoulder and mumble as they read. Sing the, this is the song that ever ends song. Sing the, this is the song that gets in everybody's nerves song. Finish the 99 bottles of beer on the wall song. Get a dog and name it Dog. Tell people you only exist in their imagination. Ask people what gender they are. Ask girls if they're pregnant. Make beeping noises if a large person is walking backwards. Wear a lot of Axe. Sing along at the opera. Mow the lawn with scissors and make sure that people are watching. Finish all your sentences with the words in accordance with the prophecy. Ask a waitress for an extra seat for your imaginary friend. Stare at the static on the TV and claim only you can see the magic picture. Ask your parents if you can try out for 16 and pregnant. Swim on the floor. Hide fruit in random places and demand that people find them. Ask constantly who your real parents are. I'm not too fond of school. I mean, the people in it are all right, but it's you know, the learning concept that I'm having trouble grasping, as my teacher says. Especially vocab. Vocab means F-Y-R-E. It's finally dead. And that was my dark side. Don't make me angry. Another thing I like is awkward moments. That awkward moment when you're taking a shower and you find out you have a birthmark that looks like Obama's face. That awkward moment when you're trying to impress some girls and while doing so, you walk into a massive spider web and you start karate chopping wildly. And the spider lands on your chest and you start to scream and run aimlessly. That awkward moment when no one likes or comments on your funny status. That awkward moment when you talk to yourself and you realize that someone else is in the room. That awkward moment when you stay home alone and you blast your music as loudly as possible while singing it at the top of your lungs, only to find out that your sister stayed home alone too. That awkward moment when you find out that your toys made 3 movies behind your back. That awkward moment when you fart in class and everyone knows that it was you and you still try to blow it off on the person next to you. That awkward moment when someone catches you singing "I'm sexy and I know it" to yourself. And last but not least, that awkward moment when your parents walk into the room when you're making a video blog and ask what you're doing. Wait, this one's funnier. That awkward moment when you realize you were dead the whole time. Now, here are some of my pet peeves on Facebook. When someone types their status as, "I'm not like most girls," and they are exactly like most girls. When someone has a photo album titled "Photography" and it's 157 photos of their eye taken with webcam and it's gone through Instagram. When someone makes their status, "Oh my gosh, today was the worst day ever," and then says, "I don't want to talk about it," when someone asks. When someone makes their status, people are so desperate for likes. Like if you agree. When someone makes a Facebook status about how much they hate Facebook. When someone breaks up with someone else and then they put their relationship status as divorced. Has 4,821 posts about how much they love their best friend. When someone posts a vague status for attention. When someone puts their relationship status as they're married to their best friend. When someone posts that they wish that airplanes could be shooting stars because they really need a wish right then. When someone changes their profile picture every hour. When people brag about how many friends that they have, when in reality they don't know any of them. "Like this and I'll rate your looks." When someone mistakes Facebook as Twitter. When someone posts a status that says, "I'm so ugly," and then she gets millions of comments from her friends encouraging her. When someone is born in 1998, and then they state that they're such a 90s kid. That's enough. Whoa, I changed rooms and you didn't even know. So every year at my school, the whole 8th grade has to make a toothpick bridge out of toothpicks and Elmer's white glue. Now that's hard enough, but the bridge has to be 49 centimeters long and at least 4 inches wide, which I barely made the cut. Now there's 24 kids in my grade, and the competition was kind of hard for only 4 people. So basically my science teacher puts weights on each bridge in front of the whole school, and then he records how much weight each bridge held. My bridge got 2nd place, and it lost to an Asian's bridge who got 201 pounds. So it doesn't really count. I think that I got 1st place in my heart since I lost to an Asian. He kind of used his powers and cheated.
I mixed together blue and yellow and got Blello!
What's up with Phineas and Ferb? On their theme song, it says they have 104 days of summer. Now, I only have 68 days. I want to go to that school. By the way, where do they live? And I know for a fact that they don't have 104 episodes. According to Wikipedia, as of June 1st, 2012, Phineas and Ferb have a total of 160 episodes. That's not fair. So guys, I have some shout outs to give out. A shout out to fire, because ninjas can't catch you if you're on fire. A shout out to vegetarianism. I hate global warming. It took away all my snow days. You know the real problem when you boil it all together? It's cow farts. You got your gas guzzling cars and your hairspray. No, look it up. The leading cause of global warming is methane. And methane is mostly found in cow farts. So that means that all cows are basically lactose intolerant. Screw off cows, taking my snow days away. Everybody needs to be like me, a vegetarian. Since no one's eating meat, there's no demand, and there's less reproduction of cows. And then I get my snow days back, easy as that. Shout out to speedometers and cars. According to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle, stated simply, we cannot know where or how fast subatomic particles are going at the same time. So if you look at a speedometer on a highway and see that you're going 60 miles per hour, you might not even be in the car. And when you look up and see that you're still in the car, you could be going 3 miles per hour. You don't know. So if you're in a long car trip and your brother is bothering you, just look at the speedometer and close your eyes and wait. A shout out to Albert Einstein for figuring out E equals mc squared. E equals mc squared is energy equals mass in kilograms times the speed of light squared. My energy is 107 pounds, which is 49 kilograms, times the speed of light twice. That means that my energy is higher than the surface of the sun this minute. Take that, bullies. Next time you come at me, I'm gonna release the energy in my little finger. Boom! You won't know where you're going or how fast you're going. Shout out to the anthropic principle. We are the way we are because we are the way we are. If Earth was 10 miles closer or 10 miles farther than the sun, we would all die. If you change one thing, it'll all be different. It's not that all fish end up in water or all people end up on land. It's just the fish on land died and all the people in the water died. If the molecular structure of oxygen changed by 0.01%, oxygen wouldn't combine correctly with hydrogen, forming dihydrogen oxide, aka water. So we wouldn't breathe oxygen. Instead of being human, we would be some purple mucoid species, breathing nitrogen, sucking nutrients off the floor of the ocean with our noses. So next time you look in the mirror and think, hey, I'm a pretty good looking dude, thank the anthropic principle.